if you're young, you're like, what? If you're older, you're like, oh yeah, I know those. Just so you know. I think, I don't know. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today, three looks combining these two palettes. The Tribe from Juvia's Place and the Violet from Juvia's Place. So yeah, this is look number three, and this was not thought of by me, or at least the color combination was not thought of by me, because my husband picked the color combination. But if you want to know what specific colors I use and how I got there, you kind of need to see the third look. Timestamps will be down below in the description box. And I had a lot of fun creating all the different looks. I think that these two palettes complement each other very, very nicely. I want to combine my other minis that I have, all four minis from Juvia's Place. I want to combine them with the other Juvia's Place palettes that I have. Some of you already had requests. I wrote them down. They are coming. I just don't know exactly when, because this is such a fun thing for me to do. I don't know when I will kind of sprinkle them on top of my channel. That was weird English, but you probably get my meaning. Yeah. Timestamps, I said that. Makeup will be there as well, down below. Yes, I am rambling. It's getting annoying. Without further ado, let's just get into the rest of the video. So grab a drink. Grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one. Okay, well, my camera was doing wonky stuff while I was filming it. So I have this already, but I will show you there what I did. First, I primed my eyes with my Kiko Milano eyeshadow base. And then I went in with the color Masai from the Tribe palette. My eyeshadow base is not set, and I'm going to press this into place a little bit in the high crease. I'm taking my time to build this color up because I want it as vibrant as possible. Okay, I also want it underneath my eye. Switching brushes, and I'm going to use a different color too. I'm going to use the color called Tootsie. It's going to go in the low crease in the outer corner. I'm placing it first, and then I'm going to blend it up and in. Doing circular motions, but just circles in, not circles out. Because if I do circles out, I'm going to drag it down, and I don't want that. And I'm checking regularly to see if the shape is the way that I want it, or that I want it a little bit higher here. Also bringing that green in a little. And I'm also connecting it up, still stamping, and then kind of flicking it in. I know I want that green a little bit more on my lid. So I'm just stamping it on. Now I'm grabbing my NYX Glitter Primer and a flat brush. And the primer is going on my brush. And on my lid, where I have no shadow yet. And I'm doing kind of a faux cut crease. So I'm stretching my eyelid down. And I'm basically creating that half moon shape for the shimmer. Okay. Then I'm going into the violets for this shade. Now that one is going to go on my eyeball. I'm just taking my time and building up the color. And then here, I'm just going to tap over. I haven't put any glitter glue there, so I'm grabbing just a tiny bit of shimmer. And I'm just tapping it over that green. I also kind of want it underneath my eye. Okay, and then I'm going to go back into the Tribe. For this color again. And I'm just going to make sure that the outer part here is nice and blended. For eye pencil, the Catrice Velvet Matte Lip Pencil in the color Tasty Aubergine. And then a little bit of the violet. Okay, inner corner highlight is going to be the color Coral. Okay, and I also kind of want that there, so just to give a little bit of a sparkle. I like this. Let's do the same on the other side as well. Liner and mascara is on, and here is the look just before the falsies. I like it a lot. So, I am going to put on my falsies. I'm going to choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the finished look. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Everything is on, and here is the finished look. I really, really like how it turned out. For lippy, I chose the Jeffree Star Velour Liquid Lipstick in Self Control, which is kind of like there. And I think it is very, very fun. I don't wear this color often, and maybe I should wear it more. So this was the first look combining these two palettes. And let me know down below how you like this look. If you would do this, if you would rock the look, let me know down below. And let's get ready for the next one. So look number two. And today I want to combine the oranges and the purples. The annoying thing is that last night before I went to bed, I kind of had an idea what I wanted to do. And now I'm kind of, what was it again? I think I know, but yeah, I think my plan was the orange shimmer on the lid. That was my plan. So if you, I don't know if I said that in the, if I said it already, but if you kind of want to combine these two palettes, the mattes will not mix nicely. Just because of the color story, they are opposite the color wheel. If you kind of combine them, they turn muddy. I don't usually mind that, if that is the look that I'm going for. So that is the reason that I'm combining the mattes from one color and then the shimmers from another. So to kind of combat that, if that makes any sense at all. I hope so. I am going to start with, I'm going to start with this one, which is the dark purple from the Violet palette. It's going to go my outer corner and the low crease. I did prime my eyes already with my favorite Kiko Milano eye base. I have not set it. And I'm just going to build this up slowly. Starting in the outer corner. And then kind of work it in. I am working in smaller sections because my base is still tacky. And the reason I'm kind of doing the weird face is to make sure that my eyelid is as taut as possible, so I don't get those creasy foldy thingies. If you're young, you're like, what? If you're older, you're like, oh yeah, I know those. Just so you know. Oh, Lord. I crack me up sometimes. Okay, let's build it up a tiny bit more. And now I am placing the shadow and not really blending because I already kind of blended the edge a little. Now I'm just placing and dragging it in a bit. Okay, tiny bit, just connected to the bottom lash line. Oh, and if you're wondering where my plugs went, apparently I'm allergic to the coppery thing that's here. So yeah, so I'll put just some others in, actually. Yeah. Okay, I kind of want to blend it out, and I kind of want to blend it out with this nice, I don't know, lavendery shade. Oh no, someone is coming into the room. No.
Hello
baby.
Hello. You feeling?
Yes. We go together nicely, purple and that neon-y greeny.
Lime green. I think I
don't. Yeah,
it's green.
I don't know. Outside it's like lime green and yellowish, and here it's like, I don't know what kind of color it is, but it's cute. Was that everything?
Yes.
Okay. to kind of help give a nice gradient between the two, I'm grabbing a fluffier brush in the darkest purple. And I'm just going to run it there. It kind of saves a little bit of blending. And it just makes sure that the gradient is a little bit better. I do want it darker in the outer corner and here. I'm just going to place shadow until I'm happy. Okay, let's get some face powder and a clean fluffy brush just to, I don't know, help make the edge of the purple nice. Or, you know, I don't know, a flesh colored matte eyeshadow. It's the same thing, same principle as I'm doing now. What was my plan again? My plan was to put the orange on the lid. So let me grab my NYX Glitter Primer and a flat brush. Yeah, I want that color because that was the color I had set my eyes on today. This color from the tribe called Curla. Oh, Curla, I have no idea how to pronounce that. Gorgeous orange that's going to go on my lid. I'm starting here in the center. I love this combination so much. I'm grabbing a little bit more of the purple matte, the dark purple matte, just for the outer corner. And because this is kind of a matte and a shimmer, you can kind of, you can mix a little bit. Shimmers are also easier to mix together without them really getting muddy, just because of the shimmer that's in there. That kind of combats a lot, you know? Yeah, that's cute. Okay. Let me do that on the other eye too, so I'm kind of even. I kind of had envisioned something green there. So let me do that, because yeah, why not? I have a very tiny brush. I'm going to go into the color called Tootsie. Yes, let's do that. Let's kind of make this a very colorful look today. Because I can. It's going to go here. I don't know if I like it, but we will see. Okay, let's grab an eye pencil. That was a weird sentence. Okay, now I want a kind of a shimmery lower lash line because I like that. So first I'm going to go back to the violet palette for this dark shimmer. It's going to go there somewhere. I'm going to spray, if I can find it, yes. And let's pull it up a little bit in the outer corner too, to connect it with the matte there. And kind of really darken up that outer corner. I actually really like putting a matte or a shimmer in the outer corner too. I'm kind of wiggling a little to get them to mix a bit. I think I want the color called Coro next, which is this one, because I think that if I put it on that that green that I have now, it kind of the green will pop a bit more. I'm going to spray that too. Oh yeah, like that. Very colorful eye. Oh Lord, I'm going to pull it here as well a little. Just to tie everything together. Let's get a different brush for that. So I'm just taking my Morphe one in the color Coro that I have been using. And I'm going to kind of mix it here in my inner eye part thingy. Cute. I kind of like this. So what I'm going to do now is eyeliner and mascara. And then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. So hold on tight. Don't go anywhere. Liner and mascara is on. And here is the look just before the falsies. I did add an inner corner highlight from my BH Cosmetics Duolight Highlight Palette, the shade called Double Take, this one, which is a little bit greeny, like that. Look, I'm going to finish it off with lashes and a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the finished look, so hold on tight, don't go anywhere. So everything is on, and here is the completed look. I really, really like it. I feel like a very cutesy, peacocky, thingy, majingy, whatever. It was, as per usual, a lot more dramatic and bold than I had planned. But yeah, I do really like how the look turned out. I'm actually glad that I paired it with the green because it kind of gives an extra little pop, funky, whatever stuffy. So the falsies I have on are from AliExpress. They will be linked down in the description box. The lippy combination I have on is a pencil from Kiko Milano. It is the Smart Fusion lip pencil in the color 536, which is a cool tone brown. And then I paired it with a lip gloss from I Heart Revolution. It's one of their chocolate lip glosses in the color Honeycomb. I love this color so much that I have a backup that is downstairs in my bag. Just saying. But yeah, this was look number two, and let's get ready for look number three. So the last look with the tribe and the violet palette by Juvia's Place, and I had still so many ideas floating around in my head that I was like, I don't know what I want to do, so please pick for me. So I asked my husband and my son, and my son was like, so my husband picked colors, and he picked this one, Ormo, and then Chaga and Koro, so these three, and then from the violet palette this one or this one, because they are the same shade. It was I could decide if I wanted to use a shimmer or a matte, so yeah, I kind of swatched it out here, and yeah, it is a very cute color story. So I have a fluffy brush. I'm going to go to the tribe for the color called Oromo. Maybe I will pull in this one to deepen it up, but I'm not sure yet, so I'm going to start with that. Now, I have primed my eyes, they are not set, and I'm just going to stamp this on, starting in the outer corner, and then working the way in. Blending the edges a little. And then for there, I'm grabbing face powder. It is the matte base powder from Revolution in the shade P2, but it is a little bit of a, I've said this before, I think, a fattier powder. And it's so easy to use. I'm grabbing a smaller brush. This is a Jessup 230 and the color Ormo, that orangey matte. I'm going to put it underneath my eye, but a little bit lower. Okay, so I have an idea. I'm grabbing the orangey matte. Let me just kind of build up some orange matte. And I'm basically working from the outside in. And I don't want to go beyond that point. I'm going to go to my Morphe M507. I'm still working with the orange. But I can blend a little bit easier with this. And I want it a little bit more orange in the crease. I am going to grab the color Ashanti too, the brown. I know it wasn't really in my color scheme, but I kind of need a little bit of depth. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a tiny bit, put it in the outer corner and the crease, and then layer the orange matte on top again. Okay, then a tiny bit of the orange. Yes, I want that too. I want my NYX Glitter Primer and the flat brush. With the side that does not have the glitter primer on it, I'm going to go into shade called Kurla, which is the orangey shimmer. Just lightly, and I'm going to place it here. In the outer corner. Damn, that was not the shade that I was supposed to use. I grabbed the wrong shade, so let me grab the right shade. That is this one. Let me put that on top. I'm cleaning the brush, then the side that has glitter primer on it, I'm going to go to this shade. And it's going to go everywhere. I don't have any eyeshadow yet. This is such a cool shade. Okay, I'm just going to pull it a little bit higher here in the inner eye part thingy. Now this in and of itself is a gorgeous look actually. I do want to blend there a little bit. So one side of the brush is going into Koro, the other side is going into Changa. And I'm going to mix them by just kind of pulling them on top of each other. And wiggling around a little. That's better. Okay. Now I have the purpley left. I'm going to put on an orange eye pencil first. So I have here an orange from Colourpop. I think it's Poppy. I don't know. The name has rubbed off, so I don't know. So I have here the LA Girl, what is it, Goldmine. It's going to go on top. I'm grabbing a small brush in the color called Chaga. I'm going to spray and I'm going to put it on my lower lash line. I'm going to go next to the color Coro, which I have there. So basically I'm mimicking what I have on my upper lash eye part thingy, whatever. Yes, I have the purple left. I did not forget. I know. Let me grab a different brush. Let's grab the shimmery, lavendery goodness. And let's plop that here. Make sure it mixes a little bit. So I think this is it so far. I don't know if I want it a little bit more intense there, the purple. I'm not sure yet. What I'm going to do first is liner and mascara. And then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. Yes. Mascara and liner is on. And here is the look just before the falsies. I did add a little bit of extra purpliness in the inner corner. I just took the same brush that I used. Picked up a little bit of shadow, sprayed it and put it in the inner corner. And I also kind of blended it up just a little bit to kind of help. Oh yeah, and I made a boo-boo here by accident. So I made a boo-boo there by on purpose. So that the boo-boos are kind of the same on my eye. Wow. Anyway, I am going to put on my falsies now. Put on the lip combination that I have chosen. And then I will be back to show you the finished look. And we can close off the video. So hold on tight. Don't go anywhere. Everything is on. And here is the finished look. I really like how the look turned out. It is something a little bit different. And I like actually that in the inner corner. I think it complements the look very, very nicely. And it kind of gives it a little bit of a different feel, you know. I could have paired it with my Jeffree Star, what is it called again? And this one, which would have been gorgeous. But I actually didn't. I thought let's kind of do a, I don't know, kind of an off-toned nude. So the lip combination that I have on is a pencil from Kiko Milano. A Smart Fusion lip pencil in the color 536. And then the lip combination is a liquid lipstick from Miss Young Fashion Matte in the color 11. That I got from AliExpress. Which is a very, very, very matte, liquid lipstick. That was the word I was looking for. And then on top of that, I put the iHeart Revolution iHeart Chocolate Lip Gloss in the color Honeycomb. The falsies I ended up choosing are the Dubai, also from Primark, because I need to cut my Londons to length and I was lazy today. So these are a little tiny bit longer, but still, they complement the look nicely, or at least I think so. Oh, let me know down below what you thought of all the looks. Maybe you have a favorite. Maybe you would have paired these two palettes differently. Let me know down below. Everything I have on my face will be down in the description box. Timestamps will be down there as well. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you are new, definitely check out the rest of my channel for all the other content that I have there, because I do loads of different things. I love to do this and bold colorful looks, but I also love to do neutrally looks and palette bingos and collabs. And I have a Let's Talk Makeup on my channel every Monday where I go over new makeup releases and give you my opinion. So if you like that, definitely hit the subscribe button before you leave and then the bell, so you will be notified of my next upload, which will be very, very soon. Probably tomorrow. I'm not sure, but I think it will be tomorrow. So yeah, I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.